came here to move, 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 move. Let's get straight to tonight's starting lineup, brought to you by Adidas, official partner of Toronto FC and MLS. With Stefan Fry rested and John Conway suspended, Milos Kosic makes his first league start for Toronto FC against the club that drafted him last year, only to release him again early 2010. Nicholas Lindsay keeps his place, the 18-year-old academy product, in the lineup again, wide on the left side of midfield. And captain Dwayne De Rosario returns to league action after serving a one-match suspension against the Crew last week. He'll play just behind the lone striker, Maicon Santos. Well, DC United include Canadian international Dejan Yakovic in the centre of their defence. He recently played for Canada against Ukraine. Honduran teenager Andy Nahar is certainly a Rookie of the Year candidate for his performances on the right wing. But as Jason mentioned, all of the talk here tonight is about 36-year-old Jaime Moreno playing his last game for DC United after a 15-year MLS career. Nahar pushing the ball forward for McTavish, the fullback forward quickly, and Hernandez saved by Kosic, and there's the opening goal for DC United from Quaranta after just 60 seconds of play at RFK Stadium.
Well, poor Milos Kosic, he did extremely well to save the first effort, could do nothing on the second. Inside 60 seconds, Nahar plays the ball down the touchline, the ball across the face of the box, a very good ball in to the feet of Hernandez. His shot was saved, but Quaranta comes in the back post. He's wide open. Nobody tracks that run.
You see up to halfway with the left back, Jordan Gray. Jaime Moreno, the captain's armband on for DC United. It was a nice ball through looking for Boskovic, but Toronto FC managed to deal with it. Labrocca with the interception. Di Rosario. Back to Nick Labrocca. Maicon Santos is in space. Good control from the Brazilian. Maicon Santos! Oh, yes! Maicon Santos does it again! It's tied 1-1 in the 23rd minute. Maicon Santos!
Nick Labrocca, great vision from him to spot that run as well. Lovely control from Maicon Santos. As soon as he brought it down, it was sitting up nicely for him. Here's a good look at the movement there. He pulled away against the run of play there, into the space, in behind Yakovic.
Rosario find Maicon Santos, but it comes back to Maicon Santos. Poor clearance from Troy Perkins. Santos with the ball and the glancing header from Peterson. Back to Nicholas Lindsay off the post. The flag is up. De Rosario in the end putting the ball in the net, but to no avail. The assistant referee already had his flag raised. Moreno inside for Boskovic with the cushion header finding Quaranta. Back across goal, the block from Nana Atacora. He leaves it for Maicon Santos. And tipped over the bar from Troy Perkins from the Santos shot.
Di Rosario runs over the top of it. Great strike from Maicon Santos. And Troy Perkins with a strong hand to tip that one over the bar. He needed to get a touch on that as well. I think that would have gone in off the underside of the bar.
Jaime Moreno will chase forward. Milos Kosic backtracking to his goal line. Hernandez is in the middle. It went off to Guzman's arm. It's a penalty for DC United. This is his final appearance for DC United. And he has a chance to score from the spot. And he does. Make it 1:33 for Jaime Moreno.
Calm as you like. Cool finish, no panic on his face, no nerves whatsoever. He just side foots it home, has a quick look at the keeper, and then picks his spot, buries it. That's what Jaime Moreno has done his entire career. Very calm, no chance for Kosic in goal.
Nick Labrocca with the free kick. Ty Harden forward from the back, Atacora there as well. It's Di Rosario's header, and Dwayne Di Rosario ties the game. His 14th league goal of the season. It is 2-2.
Well, that's a great free kick again into the box. Good movement, though, from Di Rosario. He runs into an offside position, then gets himself back. I'm not sure he was on an onside position when the ball was kicked. He was coming back into an onside position. I think the referee's assistant gave Toronto the benefit of the doubt there. I think Di Rosario might have been offside when that ball was kicked, but a fantastic finish from Di Rosario.
Toronto FC with numbers forward. Peterson and Di Rosario both there. Lindsay finding Jacob Peterson. Di Rosario played in the middle. Di Rosario! Toronto FC take a 3-2 lead. Di Rosario, second of the game.
What a fantastic passing play from Toronto FC. They caught DC United on the break. Nicholas Lindsay drove straight up the middle, and he had the presence of mind to look left and then right. And he saw Jacob Peterson, a perfectly weighted ball. And then Peterson with another fantastic crossfield pass right into the path of Di Rosario.
Danger not clear yet. And Kosic gets down. It flashed past the post. The referee says it's a goal kick. One last chance for the home team. James with the header into the arms of Milos Kosic, and that should just about be it. It is. 2010 ends on a positive note for Toronto FC. After a year of disappointment, they win at DC United by 3-2, and that man, Dwayne Di Rosario, lifted them to victory with 2 second-half goals.